Season's greetings, tie knot lovers. Mr. C's Knot Another Tie. This advent knot is called the Christmas Rose Knot. It's another one of my original knots. Again, if any of my original knots are exactly the same as ones that are already out there, please tell me and then I can change the name to what they've called it, because I don't want to tread on anybody's toes. So, just in case you wondered what it might look like as a plain colour, I've done one in red, so red for rose. But because I've got a rose tie, that's what I've done it in. So this is the Christmas Rose Knot. This is what it looks like. Let's take it apart and let's get started. And so to start this Christmas Rose Knot off with my rosy tie, this depends on how long your tie is going to be. If you've got a really long tie, then you can wear your blade down to where you normally end up wearing it. So in this case, it's starting on the left-hand side instead of the right-hand side. Tail's going to be on the left-hand side. If, like me, you've got a fairly short tie, then this is probably going to be best worn with a waistcoat or a V-neck jumper or something. So if you're going to end up with this, it's quite short. So we're going to start off with the power pinch in the middle. I'm going to come across the top with the tail, round underneath and out to the right hand side, and then we're going to take it all the way down through and out to the left. So we take it down. It's fairly tight in here because I need to try and use as much tie as we possibly can. So we've just got this bit in the middle. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to fold my tie in half, but I don't want the edges exactly together. I want them so that when I bring them round, I can see both the edges. So this one's just slightly shorter than this one. This is going to go across the front. It's going to come up and through and down the left hand side, round the back, and then they're going to come up the right hand side and then back down through. I'll just take that through there like that. And really all we're going to do then is just repeat the same process. So I'm going to come across the front, up and through, and I'm going to go back down to the left, across the back, and then I'm going to come up and through. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to lift this one up slightly, so that I can thread my tail through, like so. And it's just going to go down there, like that. The fold's coming done. There we go. That's it. Right. And then this can go up through there. We can drop our collar down, tucking our tie underneath, cinch it up. We'll go and hide underneath there. Thank you very much. Right, and there we have our Christmas Rose Knot. Thank you very much, and I shall see you tomorrow. Season's greetings, tie knot lovers. Mr. C's Knot Another Tie. Here's another original knot I'm calling the Christmas Bauble Knot, or the Bauble Knot, depending on which way you want to do it. So basically this bit here creates the bauble, and we've got this bit on the top with the fancy bit. So this is what the bauble knot looks like. Let's take it apart and let's get started. And with this Christmas bauble knot, we're going to have our blade on the right hand side, tail on the left hand side, blade down to where you normally end up wearing it, and we're going to do the power pinch in the middle. If you're not familiar with this one, it is takes the edges to the middle, fold them back on themselves, and that will create your dimple down there. We're going to take our tail across the top. We're going to take it round, up and through. Okay, we're then going to come down to the right, round the back, and then we're going to take it up, and we're going to go over and down through, and then out to the right. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to fold it in half, and I'm just going to make a loop and come back up underneath, and I'm then going to come through. So I'm just going to just do this for a second. So I'll just fold that over there, and that is going to come through this loop here. So this will sort of lock it in place. And so what we should have, a little fold. There we go. That can then go down through that loop here, and then we can come round the back, and we can come up and through here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through that loop that we just created. And then that can go up there. And if I drop my collar down, and then we can carefully cinch this up, try not to lose any definition. And then this loop bit depends how big a bauble you want, but there is our Christmas bauble knot. Thank you very much, and I shall see you tomorrow. Season's greetings, tie knot lovers. Mr. C's Knot Another Tie here. This knot is a new one for me, and it's also by a new guy. He's called Tied Up in Sydney, and just found his by accident, so I thought I'd do one of his. It's a Christmas knot, and I'll leave a link to him as well. So this is the ribbon knot. This is what it looks like. Let's take it apart and let's get started. And with this ribbon knot, this one's a new one actually, by a new guy that I've just found. He's called Tied Up in Sydney, so I presume it's Australian anyway. So this is his knot. So I'll leave a link to his channel for you. So we're going to start off with the blade on the right-hand side, tail on the left-hand side, blade down to where you normally end up wearing it, so just above your belt line. Remember, when you cinch it up, it will drop slightly. So, our pinch in the middle. We're going to take our tail, we're going to come across the top, and we're going to come round, up, and through. And then we're going to go down to the left-hand side. We're then going to go round the back and then out to the right. And then we're going to put our finger there and we'll come across the front, round the back, and then back over again. So we do that twice. Put my finger there. And then we're going to come up and we're going to come through the top. And then, taking your tail, we're going to slide it down the inside of both of those knots. Those loops that we've just done, so it comes out of the bottom like so. And then by just separating these out slightly, we can then take our tail, and if we rotate it round and then we go up through the front one like so, and then what we can do is you can twist this one round so we end up with like that. And then it goes down the back. And then what you're going to do with this loop here, you're going to come back through this loop. Like so. And then this can be tucked underneath there. And it will go to one side. And that's what you want to do. So we drop our collar down. And if we just cinch it up, we can then just finish this off. So we can just pull this out slightly. I want to show this bit of knot here, our tail going across the top there, and there we have our ribbon knot. Thank you, and I shall see you tomorrow. Season's greetings, tie knot lovers. Mr. C's Knot Another Tie. This multicolored tie uses two ties. It's a red one and a green one, and I'm calling it the Holly and the Ivy knot. So this is what the holly and the ivy knot looks like. Let's take it apart and let's get started. And with this holly and ivy knot is what I'm calling it. So I'm using a red tie and I'm using a green tie. Green for the ivy and the red for the holly berries. So blades are on the right hand side. And what I've done is I've just put it through the back of the green tie and they're facing seam to seam. And when I go round the back, I'm giving it a twist so that I've got the red coming over the top first. So I'm going to do my power pinch in the middle, which isn't easy with two ties. I'm going to come across the top and I'm going to come up and I'm going to come through like so. And both of them are going to go down to the left hand side. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take them both of them round the back. I'm going to take the green one first. This is going to come across the front. I'm going to twist it round so it comes across the front like so, back round and then that's going to go up over the top, and then I'm going to bring it back down through that loop, so we end up with that side. Okay, and I'm just going to leave that bit there, and then with the red tie I'm going to bring it round, and I'm going to bring it across. No, it's not, it's going to go up here, beg your pardon, it's going to come up through this green one, and it's going to go through like that up on the angle. Okay, and then that is going to go round underneath and back over the top like so, and that's going to come round, and I'm going to give that a twist and fold it in half, and then so I fold this bit up, and then that bit's going to go right through the middle of those like so, and I'm just going to just drop that there and tuck it underneath just for a minute while I finish off on the green. So once this comes round, this is going to come through. I'm going to fold this in half. It's going to go underneath this one. I'm going to go through, so it's underneath this one and underneath this other one as well. That, and then that can go round the collar on that side, and this can go round the collar on that side. We can drop our collar down. I'll just neaten this out a little bit. Cinch this up, and there we have our holly and ivy knot. Thank you, and I shall see you tomorrow. Season's greetings, tie knot lovers, Mr. C's Knot Another Tie. This interesting knot is called the Hedera Helix knot. And if you wonder what Hedera Helix is, it's this stuff in the background, it's the common ivy. That's the Latin name for it, something I remembered back in my days when I went to agricultural college at Leaseith in Cheshire. So, this is what the Hedera Helix knot looks like. Let's take it apart and let's get started. And with this Hedera Helix knot, we're going to have the blade on the right-hand side, nearly forgot, the tail on the left-hand side, and the blade's going to go down to where you normally end up wearing it, so just above your belt line. Remember that it will drop when you cinch it up. Power pinch in the middle. Got no idea why it's called a power pinch. I've just picked his name, what I picked up from everywhere else. So we're going to put our tail across the top. It's going to come round up, and it's going to come through, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to fold it in half. So it's going to be, the rest of this tie is going to be in half. It's going to come down, round, and out to the right. And then with the open seams at the top, I'm going to come across the top and out to the right. And then I'm going to go back round underneath. And then I'm going to come round again. It's then going to go back round underneath. And then it's going to go up and over the top, and I'm just going to just pull it through first because it makes it life a little bit easier, and then still with it folded in half, and then going to come back through this loop here. Okay, so just like ivy in real life, it gets everywhere and will find its own way through everything. So we bring it back round. It's then going to come down, round, and then to finish off, I'm going to come underneath this one and underneath this one. So, underneath this one. Like so, just keeping it nice and tight as I go along. And then up and through there. And then I just want a little bit of spacing in it. And then that can then be tucked over the top. And just in there, pull our collar down. There, we just cinch that up, and there we have our Hedera Helix knot. Thank you, and I shall see you tomorrow. Hello, tie knot lovers, Mr. C's Knot Another Tie. This knot's called the ornament tie. It's a slight variation on Matthew Simmons' ornament tie. I think I've done the ending slightly different to what he does, but the majority of it is the same anyway. So rather than just call it a new knot, I'm just calling it the ornament knot with a slight variation on it. Anyway, this is what the ornament knot looks like. Let's take it apart and let's get started. And with this ornament knot, we have blade on the left-hand side for a change, tail on the right-hand side. Blade down to normally where you end up wearing it, so down near your belt line. Remember, it will drop slightly when you cinch it up. We're going to do the power pinch in the middle. If you're still unsure, if you're new to the channel, power pinch is where we take the edges of the tie of our blade, put them together, and then we fold them back on ourselves, and then this creates the dimple in the bottom of our tie knot. So we're then going to take our tail, we're going to take it across the top, we're going to bring it round, up and through, and then we're going to take it down to the right hand side, round the back, and then we're going to come up and we're going to come down through there. We're then going to take it round a couple of fingers, so we've got a nice big loop round underneath. So I'm going to go all the way round, and then we're going to go all the way round again, and then the third time we can then come up and through there, wrap it round the other side, and then what I'm just going to do is I'm just going to cross it like so. It's a slight variation on Matthew's. I just want it behind there, and then that can go round and up under your collar. So we can then drop this down, and then we can cinch this up, and then we can just open this up a little bit. There we go. And there we have a slight variation of Matthew's ornamental knot, or ornament knot. Let's straighten that up a bit. There we go. There, it looks a little bit better. Try showing it under. There we go. And there we have our ornament knot.